What's up, guys? I'm the PigPig Gamer. Welcome back to another tutorial where today we are actually starting a brand new series. This isn't just gonna be one tutorial. It's actually gonna be how to make your guys' own Minecraft mods for 1.10.2, and we're gonna update to different versions when they come out. So I decided to teach you guys how to make a mod because I've watched tons of videos on how to make some, and yeah, so you guys can make your own mods. If you always want me to showcase your mods, then you can make your own. And so now I'm teaching you how to do them. So first you need Java JDK 8U92, because that's the one that worked for me. So what you want to do is you just want to hit accept the license agreement, and this one's for 32-bit users. So if you're a 32-bit user, you click this one. If you're a 64-bit user, you click this one, but I'm 64-bit, so I'm gonna click this one. Now once that's done downloading, you open this to do like a setup. I already done it. If I do it again, I'm gonna have to install it again. I don't want to do that, so you guys could go through that setup or just watch another tutorial on how to do that. Next thing you need to get is Minecraft Forge. You need Minecraft Forge for this to work. So of course we're doing 1.10.2, but like I said, when the newer versions of Minecraft come out, we'll update to those. So download the MDK, not the universal, not the installers, the MDK. And it goes to an advertisement. Fantastic. That's not what it's supposed to do. So yeah, if it leads you to an advertisement, just try it again and hopefully it will work, because I want to actually show you guys how to get this forge properly, not go into an ad. So make sure you don't, if like this website changed from ad focus, yeah, this, to a different website, just
focus
exit
is a
out
revolutionary new way of making money on the internet.
And then I guess you could listen to this guy's voice if you want, but we're going to hit the skip button, and there you go. There you go, Forge 1.10.2 MDK, but we'll do that stuff in a second. But next, what you need is Eclipse. Now, Eclipse is the program we're actually going to code. If you're looking for a tutorial without coding, then this is not the series for you. There's tons of tutorials on how to do it without coding, but I love coding, so I'm going to do coding. So Eclipse, so you could download any version, you could do Neon. So just click to continue and just download any Eclipse version. So yeah, just hit the download button, and look, you get Eclipse Neon, there's like other stuff. So I just hit down. So for 64-bit, I have no idea for 32-bit users, maybe it's download packages, but I'm 64-bit, so I'm gonna hit this one, and then just hit download. And it says, thank you for downloading Eclipse, but I already have a version of Eclipse and Eclipse itself, so I'm not gonna do that. Now, let's actually get into modding. So we're gonna want to go into our downloads folder, and this is for Windows 10, so if you're like Windows 7, then maybe you could look for a tutorial on that, but this is for like Windows 10 users, so might be different for other users. So what you want to do, this is the secret of YouTube, look. Look at this, my outros, my pictures I use, there's my thumbnails, my backgrounds. I just revealed a secret. Anyway, so you go to your downloads and you find this, and then I made a folder where I put all my Minecraft mods that I make, so just do that. The code, not a mod. This is actually, I don't think you would, some people have to do this, but it worked for me. So you want to make a new folder, and we're going to call it modding. Actually, let's call it tutorial 1.10.2. Let's call it that. So this is our tutorial mod right here. So we're gonna double click this, and you wanna open the Forge MDK. I'll leave a link to WinRAR because I recommend WinRAR. If you're a Mac user, I believe there is a WinRAR for Mac out there. So what you wanna do is you wanna click any and then Control A to highlight all of them, and just drag it into your modding folder. There we go. So now what you want to do is you want to make a new text document, and we're going to call this Gradle. And then in this text document, we're going to go to our code. And then just copy this code. I'll leave the code in the description so you don't have to, like, I don't know. So just copy this. Or you can pause the video. I'll just leave it in the description anyway. And you want to paste into there. And then we'll exit out of this. And then you want to, let me just go into here. So you want to file, save as, and you want to put it in your tutorial folder. Make sure it's in tutorial, not like your desktop or something. And you want to put .properties. Make sure you spelled that correctly. Make sure it's on all files. Then hit save, exit out of this. And there's the Gradle properties. You want to delete this text document. So delete the text document. You want to exit out this. You don't need this. And then I'm just going to permanently delete this. Trito. If my mic turned off, that's because the cat. Even though you can't really hear me if the mic is off. Anyway. So, yeah. You don't have to permanently delete, but I like it because it saves up space on my computer. So, next what you want to do is you want to shift, right click, open the command window here. And what you want to put is Gradle, so you're basically accessing the batch file. And then sets up dcomp workspace. And then enter. And then what this is going to do is it's kind of confusing. I didn't learn too much about coding, if you know what I mean. Like, I still don't know much about coding, what this stuff means, but it's basically, I guess, going to set up the decomp workspace, and it's going to access the Gradle thing. So, yeah, so, I thought it failed for a second. I'm like, what did I do? But it just shows this. So, if you try this and it says build fail because of decomp LMC, put this Gradle properties in here, because that's what worked for me. Oh, I forgot to show you something very, very important. Once this is done, I'll show you what you have to do. I'm so sorry I forgot this. So sorry, guys. So sorry. Do not do this first, because I completely forgot what I have to do. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe I forgot to do that. So it's going to leave a link to the Forge stuff. So, yep, 1.10.2. Perfect. Get the pun. Anyway, So, if it's a skip, that doesn't mean it's an error, it's just that, I guess you already played Minecraft before, so, yeah, so, don't worry, it's not an error, it's just, yeah, so, if you have any problems with decomp LMC, then I would recommend make this Gradle properties. So, guys, just ignore this step if you haven't set up Java JDK yet, because it's not gonna work for you. I don't even know what it says. I would say maybe it says, like, Java not found, make sure. Something like that. So, yeah. Just ignore this step for people who haven't set up Java JDK yet. If you know what I mean. Like, you have to put in, like, a path and stuff. So, I completely forgot about that. Sorry, guys. I'm really, really sorry. I don't want to edit it so it's, like, that Java JDK and then this. Because otherwise, I'm going to say, I forget. And you guys are like, no, you didn't. You just did it. Anyway, so it's gonna decomp LMC. That was the problem most people were having. But when I made this Gradle properties, it seemed to actually fix the problem. And I already have Java JDK set up for me, so it's gonna work. Hopefully, I hope it works. It worked for me last time. It should work for me again. If it doesn't, I'm gonna do some googling, because I'm pretty sure I did every single thing. Made the Gradle properties, set up Java JDK. So, yeah. Can't believe I forgot that step, but this is gonna happen anyway. So, yeah, decomp LMC usually takes a long time. It's probably gonna take a really long time. But while this is decomping the game, hopefully no errors pop up, is, so basically we're gonna cover everything. We're gonna cover how to make an item, a dimension, a mob, blocks, like gravity blocks, if you know what I mean, maybe sand. We could learn how to do that, crafting, smelting, basically everything. So everything that's in Minecraft, if you know what I mean. Maybe biomes, maybe we could add our own biome. I have no idea. Anyway, so it's decomping the game. So yeah. And while this is decompiling, because it's still not done after all that talking, You guys seem to love the previous Five Nights at Freddy's video, so I'll make more because you guys seem to love Five Nights at Freddy's to me getting scared. The horror version, the cute, not the cute version. That's not scary, that's cute. So yeah, so if you're wondering what decomposing means, probably most of you know, I think it means just like making sure it's Minecraft. Make sure the game is Minecraft, if you know what I mean, maybe. So yeah, if this doesn't work because this is taking so long, then I might just as well cut the video up, but then I would have nothing to do. What just happened? Something weird just happened out there. Weird noises come that weird noise. I always hear weird noises from this office. It's just really weird. Hopefully I won't hear that much weird noises when my new office comes. Hopefully. So this could take 1 to 10 minutes depending on your computer speed. I've had this computer for a long time. It's probably why it's stuck on DeviantArt. So yeah, and also once I have face cam, if you see a little like gray box thing next to me, that's my old computer. I actually have it next to me just for a source, like if I forgot how to do something, maybe I'll just look over there and just look at it. It'll be useful for Crazycraft. Like I could just look up a wiki on the old computer and then just play Minecraft on this computer. So yeah, I think that would be a pretty cool thing. But once I get my new room, there's no way my old computer is going to be up there because of how dusty it is. Don't want to ruin how cool it is. So I might just use my phone once I get the new room. So yeah, so I'm going to be right back. And oh wait, it already did it. So yeah, so now it's on fixed MC sources. So yeah, see, decompose MC usually could take up to maybe 2 minutes. It took up last time I did testing on this, it didn't take, I don't think it took that long, maybe because it's a very new Minecraft version. So yeah, I also recommend download the recommended because yeah, what's this that's opened? It's a email Lenovo Messenger. Okay, there we go. That's such a useful feature. You can literally hit the X like this. That's so awesome. So now it's going to apply the source patches and all this stuff. So yeah, if you have any errors, leave, tell me in the comments below and I'll try and look up on Google stuff about it. And yeah, Recompile MC basically takes a long time too. I think it took even longer than Decompile MC for me last time I tried this, so yeah, as you can see on the right here, it generates some new folders. It generated .gradle, build, eclipse, gradle, well, those are just the default, but I don't think we saw the source folder, so I'm guessing the source is where you put all your textures and stuff like that for your items and stuff. So yeah, once I learn the code for them, I'll do a tutorial on them. Maybe we can make a mod where rubies are actually in Minecraft. That would be awesome, because rubies were an added feature. I think they were going to be added, but then they decided not to for some reason. Maybe they forgot. So yeah, I think rubies were in Minecraft a long time ago, but then they got removed, or maybe just forgot about the rubies. And I think they replaced the rubies with emeralds for some reason. Maybe they just didn't like the texture and tried changing it. And you're like, you know what? This looks like an emerald, so we're going to make an emerald. And then they forgot about the ruby. I think that's my theory of the ruby. But in this mod, we might bring back the rubies. So yeah, I have no idea what we could do. Remember, this is just a tutorial mod. You don't have to add, like, a, for example, an emerald sword. You could do, of course, you could do anything. Now, this is just a tutorial mod, so I'm doing what I want to do. But you guys can do what you want to do. Because this is your mod. You can do anything you want. Anything. Except for breaking the game, of course. That anyway, so yeah, so see what I mean? This Gradle properties really helps the get rid of that decompile MC error. So yeah, if it doesn't say skip next to it, or like, I don't know, if it's just blank like this, then don't worry, it's not an error, it's just saying that it's finished, I think. So yeah, but I know that's not an error. So it's like showing the MCP, which is also really cool, the MCP for 1.10.2. And if you know why we're doing 1.10.2 and not 1.10, it's because I don't want a bunch of bugs. I think this version fixed a bunch of bugs, which is really helpful. So there we go, recompile MC is done. Now it's gonna do all this gain asset stuff. I was gonna cut the video, but then all of a sudden decompile MC finished. So sorry if this video is really long. I apologize, but modding tutorials usually are pretty long anyway. So now it's just gonna do this status stuff, which usually not much people get an error on. It's just doing all this stuff, and you have to wait until 1110. I thought I said 1010. I'm like, that would be 110. So yeah, so and there we go, build successful. So next, what you want to do is you want to do Gradle Eclipse. This did it in 9 minutes and 5.3 seconds. This tutorial I know is more than 5 minutes. So next, you want to do Gradle Eclipse, and I guess this is gonna detect that you're gonna use Eclipse to code. So yeah, I know you do have to put the code in, and then right at the end it puts set decomp workspace, and then yeah, so build successful, yay. Oh, I used to have so much trouble with that one command, because I kept saying that decompile MC failed, but when I made this Gradle properties, it helped. So see what I mean about this? If it didn't work for you the first time, then I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to start again. But before you do that, you make this Gradle properties. Oh jeez, this Gradle properties. So here we go. This usually takes the shortest, so it's gonna make the start so Minecraft can start up and build successful. That did it in 38.497 seconds. That must be a record. So now we got all the code, we got some new folders in here, and now I can show you how to set up Java JDK. Make sure you do that before you do what I just did, okay? Otherwise it's not gonna work. So what you wanna do is you wanna right click on this PC. Want to go to properties, and then advanced system settings, Windows 10 Home Edition, actually. So, see, 64-bit. I told you. Anyway, so it's going to environment variables, and then you want to make two. You want to make one called Java Home, and let's go into our path, shall we? So, we're gonna go in this menu. I'm very used to Windows 10 now. I've been on it for a while. So, you want to go to this PC. You want to go to your hard drive, I guess. And then program files are 86, but mine's just in here. So, Java JDK 92. You want to double click on that. You want to go to bin. You want to do this. Control. Wait, is it just? Wait, I forgot it was slash bin. No, it's not slash bin. Do not do slash bin. Okay, just do this. Just do that. So do this, control C, and want to edit this, and then control V, but I already done it, so I don't need to do it, but I did it anyway. And then next, you want to go to your path, so you want to hit edit, and then this one, you put the bin, so you want to do that, and then just go to bin, control A, control C, and then control V, but I don't need to do it, so I already done that. So anyways, you want to hit okay, and then okay, and then okay, and then exit out this, and then exit out this. Do that before you do the CMD thing for people who didn't set up Java JDK in their path. So now what we can do is we could go into Eclipse and actually see if this worked. I'm on Eclipse Mars 1, so I guess if you want to download this version, then just search Eclipse Mars 1 and maybe some downloads will pop up. Or if you want to get Eclipse Neon, because it actually looks pretty cool, then you can get that too. Love the loading screens of Eclipse, they just look super epic. They are awesome. Love them. So I believe it's going to load up my off-camera 1.7.10 modding. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. Yeah, this is where we show... This is the folder with the electronic lucky block mod. Did I really showcase that in 2015? I don't think I did. Anyway, see, I made a villager face. I don't know why, I just did. Anyway, so you want to go switch workspace if this pops up. When you first start Eclipse, though, it's going to pop up with this automatically. But if you didn't download for the first time, it's just going to bring you to your coding stuff. But they want to hit change workspace, then just do other. And then you want to hit browse. And then you want to go to your modding folder. So here's our tutorial. So yeah, make sure it's in your folder if there's any folder. And then you in your tutorial folder, you want to do Eclipse and then hit OK. So here we go. Here it is. So now it's saving the workspace and then it's going to load the Minecraft environment. So yeah, this is gonna be awesome. If you can't expand MDK example, that's because Decapole MC failed, or Recapole MC, I think. I think it's Decapole MC. Maybe both. So it's loading the Minecraft environment, and here we go. So we have MDK example, so we can hit this arrow here. And then we have source main Java, and then we have the example mod, example mod.java. So it's gonna load up in a second. So yeah, this is what it should look like, except if you can't expand it, of course. So here we go, we got the example mod, and let's run Minecraft to see if it actually worked. Hopefully it did, because I'll be very upset if it didn't. Okay, it's launching the client. So here we go, hopefully this works. And then we can move on. Next, we have to set up the first files, then we might make our first item, a blocks. All that awesome stuff. Here we go, launching Minecraft. Don't worry about this born unable to thing, I don't think it really matters that much. So long as Minecraft doesn't crash, then you're good, you're good. So here we go, it's saying user player 667. Make sure I didn't say the devil number then. So there we go, Minecraft starting up. Let me just click this, and then there we go. 1.10.2. That's exactly the version we want. So it's constructing the mod. Sometimes it can't respond. How is it not responding when this is moving? That's really weird. It actually updated it, so it doesn't just go back in there. It actually just goes out, which is really cool. The hammer. I love that hammer. It's so awesome. Again, not responding when that is moving. How weird is that? That's probably gonna look weird with a white screen, actually. That would be weird. Okay. So, if it don't respond, just don't click it, because otherwise the screen turns white, and you know what happens, the thing breaks, so... Yeah, I don't know how it's moving when it's not responding. That's very weird. Very spooky, actually. So, yeah, it just loads all this, all the blocks. Loads all the models. So everything should be working fine, and then it does the items, so it does all that. There's like 371 items, jeez. And then we have the baking, which that has a ton of items, and then it loves the iron renderer, and then completes the Minecraft initialization, and it doesn't respond. Again, why does this always happen? It's every single mod tutorial, it's probably gonna take a while to actually start up the game. But anyway, yeah, so again, just I'll put like a little thing once I'm saying up, because I didn't say it when I actually typed it in. So yeah, you also hear me say it on the say up Java JDK. I can't believe I forgot that. Jeez, So, yeah, it's just doing all this model stuff again. And then it does, I believe, the actual textures. And there we go! Look at that! 1.10.2, 4 mods loaded. And then we have our example mod. Let's go into full screen, actually. Let's go to single player, and we're gonna call it modding. I'm gonna create a super flat. I wanna have some villages, so type in that. That's the village Mr. Pig was in, except he's not gonna be with me. This is just a different world. Replica of it! Yeah, replica. Oh my gosh, you can't see this, sadly, but in the reflection, I look like a dirt man. Oh, no, I don't. Okay, anyway, here we are. I'm just a little Steve arm. Just a little Steve. So. Is there a village anywhere? Because there's supposed to be a village near spawn. He has to see villagers. Hey guys! How's it going? Whoa, I forgot about these new paths in 1.10. They're awesome. I believe these are the new plants. It's lagging a little bit, probably because I'm recording and have Eclipse open. We also got this carrot. Mr. Pig would love that. Let me just... this music. I'm gonna turn it down. Sorry. I know the music is awesome, but I'm gonna turn it off. So, look at this! Pigs! Pigs everywhere! Mr. Pig's everywhere! He cloned himself! The villagers have done it! Once again! Just kidding, these are just- Oh jeez, I'm so sorry! These are just pigs. These are Mr. Pig. Oh my gosh, I make a baby. I made so many babies! I can still hear the music, but I can't really because of how many oinks. Look! Look at this villager! He's looking at the pig's butt. Stop. No, he's showing off his butt! Stop looking at his butt! He's gross. He's so gross. Anyway, it's also the church and stuff. So guys, this is the world where we're gonna test our awesome stuff with mods. All that awesome stuff. So, if you guys want to see more of this, then definitely hit that big fat like. If this, and you can also suggest what you want to see, items, blocks, but next time we have to set first files and then you can suggest them if you want to, because I think I'm planning to do like items after, if you guys want to see how to make your own items. Even though I don't do much, they would look cool in your Minecraft world anyway. So, if you did enjoy this video, if you got any errors, then just tell me in the comments below and I'll try and fix that as soon as possible.